on the one hand, I was really happy because that meant I had more time to figure out what to do about the police situation. I was a little worried too. The snow was already up to our mailbox and it wasn't showing any sign of stopping. Mom wasn't stressed out about the snow though. She said it was a good opportunity to slow down and relax and told me I could go down in the storage room to get the puzzles, but there was no way I was getting a puzzle from the storage room. I had a big phobia about puzzles, and that's because when I got the one out of the basement, I opened it and it was full of crickets. That had made a nest there. After lunch, Mom said that even though we were going to miss school, she would gonna make sure that we didn't fall behind in our education. She said that 200 years ago, all the kids went to the school on one classroom, and that we could do the same sort of thing in our house.
Thank you.
I am busy packing a few essentials for Derek's house when this time Dad comes up to see me. Apparently, Mom didn't think I am taking my review homework seriously. Dad says I have to do it again properly, which is a bit harsh. Okay, I admit my review was short, but true. Dad suddenly holds a packet of waffles. Go to sleep over when you've done your homework again, okay? Suddenly, I am very inspired. In fact, I have a total brainwave to get my homework done in double quick time. I'm a genius. I run downstairs and grab the first book from the shelf that looks thick, but not too thick. Mom sees that I'm holding a book and assumes that time plus thick equals secret attempt at homework. She looks pleased.
Thank you, Yara.
Life is so unfair. One good thing happened today. I had my first Minecraft mod in class. When we got into class, the teacher explained how Minecraft mods work, but the mod's effect was only temporary. It would last a few hours. We were only allowed to do basic mods. The advanced ones were dangerous. Only the military and the programs of modern used them. Our mods only change the color.
Thank you very much, Chuck.
Well, I thought he was Mr. Mumboy. He stood with his hand on Jacob's shoulder. He and his other friend, Lucius, got a silly book, not in COVID. Busy time at the ministry, I hear, said Mr. Mumboy. All those days, he looked at the angel all the time. He reached into Jimmy's shoulder and strapped it from a mixture of glossy Lockhart books. A very old, very battered copy of A Beginner's Guide to Transfiguration. Obviously not, Mr. Malfoy said. Dear me, what's the use of being a disgrace to the name of Zubber if they don't even pay you with us? Mr. Ridley flushed darker than their words again. He has a very different idea of what disgraces are, the name of Wizard Malfoy himself. Clearly, said Mr. Malfoy, his fear of staring to Mr. and Mrs. Sanders, who were watching at the moment.
Thank you, the chair.